Grange Park 911, where's emergency?
Good evening. Linda's off tonight at El Arakawa is sitting in, and it was dinner time just after 6 o'clock on this rainy night in LaGrange Park when neighbors began seeing flashes of light and hearing thunderous cracks. Suddenly, a lightning bolt struck the place they call home. Fire broke out immediately. Here's home video from the scene. You can see the smoke, thick and gray, pouring from the roof, and flashes of flames in one apartment just below where the lightning bolt hit. Firefighters had to smash the glass in that burning apartment. Three firefighters tonight are suffering from heat exhaustion. It all happened in the western suburb of LaGrange Park.
Hello. The film you are about to see, I'd like to dedicate to the officers and fire personnel that responded to the call on March 5th, 1992. The 211 alarm in the village of LaGrange Park. I am Chief Art Tullis, and I was in charge of that fire. With the MABAS Division 10, professional work its members displayed that night. Another example has shown how MABAS does work. Thanks again, and I hope you enjoy the film.
Grange Park Fire Department, general alarm for structure fire.
The people stopping some oil from the roof. And there's no smoke. Hope you can see this for a very limited amount. March 5th, 1992, at approximately 6:15. Top two is in ventilation in action. 631
will be your staging. Okay, nobody is staging at this time.
Message received.
Nobody is staging. Who's our six?
Here we are back on Homestead. Back at you with the top crew. Taking some pictures. We'll zoom in for a nice close up of that heavy smoke. Gee, looks like backdraft almost.
Okay, here we are in the rear. We got new positions to our air station. So, 438 from that screen. That's all for you. That's the road. Coming in here, we have assignment LCI 1990, straight stick from the Grange Park. Here we have a dedicated firefighter standing here holding the hole. Looks like we've got some fire up here. Moving the ladder. Back up a little bit. Smoke's going. Getting down. Here we have one of our top injured paramedics going up the ladder with the hotel bag. To the roof sector. We got all this fire going out the eaves. We got a lot of smoke. A lot of work to do. We got a distance reporter. Putting some water into the eaves.
Escalating the box to a 211 to 418 Homestead, same route. Staging will be Homestead. We need relief here. We do not necessarily need equipment. We need manpower.
Okay, so you get two engines and a squad and additional chief on that level.
Okay, message received.
Division 10. Manhattan, all locals. The LaGrange Park Fire Department requesting a 211 alarm on their box number one for the structure fire at 418 Homestead in LaGrange Park. Units due to respond are Westchester with an engine, Clarendon Hills with an engine to the scene, Riverside with a squad, and Brookfield with a chief. Clarendon Heights, you're due to change quarters to LaGrange Park, station number one at 447 North Catherine. Area is at Homestead and Woodlawn. Units due to respond, switch to and acknowledge on the near-front frequency. KY, can I assist you?
Pleasant View, Clarendon Heights,
masked up and ready to go. It's your engine here.
second line up here by the banger ladder down here on the east end.
Okay, I got some fresh crews on their way and we'll be working on it.
Buster 6, thank you. 422 from C2. Dropping that Cisco and running another line up this front door.
How can the base get three quarter now?
That's a great speed. We can hit it right from the front door here.
C2 from Albury.
Go ahead.
I have a 200 foot three connect coming to you right now up the back. An additional one up a 322.
All right, charge that one in the front door of 418. We got it.
So I have Westchester's crew coming over. Captain and three men. He's going to report to you. Put him to work.
Live now on the scene, Channel 2's Lester Holt. Lester?
Bill, behind me the sound of tapping hammers in broken glass. Salvage crew is now beginning to board off the damaged apartments. You may be able to see the red tarp protecting some items streaming out of the window of one of the broken-in apartments, or apartments that was damaged by water, we should say. We've been told that at least six residents will not be returning to their homes tonight, their apartments so severely damaged. Eight others have been told they can go back in. The power is on. They will spend the night here. Lucky, despite the fact this freak storm singled out their building. Last snowflakes of winter likely haven't been heard from, so tonight's crushing bolt of lightning was a double surprise, igniting the roof of this four-story apartment building into thick smoke and flame, and sending the mostly elderly residents fleeing into the rain. Firefighters had to dig their way through the roof to get at the flames. In the parking lot below, worried relatives search for loved ones who live in the building. Nearby, Red Cross workers were accounting for everyone. Fortunately, no one was injured, but heavy water damage may leave some temporarily homeless. Why this building? Firefighters cannot even guess. Lightning, says the fire chief, is a funny thing. A thing most around here had never seen so close. The fire was inside the roof, and it was very difficult to fight. This was a new roof and very well built, according to firefighters. They had to cycle firefighters back and forth, some overcome by heat exhaustion. In fact, three are being treated tonight at LaGrange Hospital. They're expected to be released before this night is over. We're live in LaGrange Park. I'm Lester Holt, Channel 2 News.